My dad was a biologist at the University of Connecticut, and my mom worked for the Natural History Museum at the university, and then she was a science teacher. So I grew up in a culture of science. We were immersed in it. My brother and I used to go to Long Island Sound to pick up marine samples, and we'd catch frogs, spring peepers in ponds around Connecticut. So this is how we grew up. It was really kind of magical with that. And as I progressed, became more interested in how our bodies work, how they fail, and for some reason, how the heart in particular, because it beats nonstop, of course, how that fails. And that really led me into medicine and eventually into cardiology. I focus on heart rhythm problems. And so the main bulk of that is probably atrial fibrillation. That's what I see primarily. But it's also patients that have pacemakers or need pacemakers or defibrillators. And as I tell my kids, you put a pacemaker in when it's too slow and off an ablate when it's too fast and it's irregular. And so that's kind of how it boils down. We also treat SVT, which is a more regular heart rhythm disorder, ventricular tachycardia, which comes from the bottom chamber of the heart. And I mentioned before, pacemakers and defibrillators, which we tend to place either when someone has a slow heartbeat, they have heart failure, or they're at risk for an abnormal heart rhythm that could actually lead to sudden cardiac death. With all your patients, that there should be a place where you're trying to treat them like their family and develop that trusting relationship, because the things that we're likely to suggest, they probably haven't heard of before. If they have, it seems like science fiction, or it's hard to believe that someone could actually do something like that in a person's heart. And so that trust has to be there.